Good Thursday morning, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austin Onick. We've got another bone-chilling cold morning for the Mid-South area with temperatures, again, well on down into around the single digits at this time. So we do have, again, the potential for a very cold start to the morning. Excuse me for just one second here. Have to kick the computer into gear here for just a second. Time is just past the top of the hour, and things, again, are very much on the cold side across much of the Mid-South area. We're going to continue to see that off and on throughout the rest of the day. Winds are dropping, so we don't have a lot of wind chills, again, expected into the rest of the day. But if you're doing anything outdoors this morning, definitely want to plan ahead for that, especially the kids. This is not jacket and ball cap type weather. Need to make certain that you've got layers on before you head out the door, especially if you're going to be outdoors for a long period of time. Again, wind chills in parts of the Mid-South near zero for this morning, and going to continue to see some pretty chilly conditions off and on throughout the next few days. Plus, as we go into the next couple of days, we've got some big changes coming up where we go into New Year's, including the possibility of some winter weather heading our direction. We'll talk more about that coming up here in just a little bit. If you can't stick around for the whole forecast, if you've never seen this before, this is our video weather blog, our exclusive video weather blog called Weather Overtime. If you've never seen this, again, email address. If there's anything you'd like to talk about here on the email, social media sites where I hang out at, where you can contact me as well. And our main webpage, again, available at wreg.com/weather. 7-day forecast available here. Immediate forecast available down here in the blue bar at the bottom of your screen. And, of course, a quick check of the forecast for Thursday as we get closer to the weekend. So, again, temperatures over the next several hours will be topping freezing. That hasn't seen that in much of the Mid-South for the last couple of days. So a lot nicer out there today than what it has been. Granted, this is not exactly balmy, but it's an improvement in the temperatures, so that's very nice to see. And if you're going to be heading out the door pretty soon, again, expect some cold temperatures through the day. Not quite as bone-chillingly cold as it was for the last couple of days, but we'll talk more about that coming up here in just a little bit. Welcome to everybody who's checking in on Facebook. Drop your location, and if you've got a weather report in the area, temperature, cloud cover, wind speed, wind direction, put that thermometer or weather station outside to good use and let everybody know what's going on where it comes to weather. We'll pass along any information that you see in the comment section there, and thanks to everybody for getting up early and joining us at this time. Wind chills in the Mid-South. This is the big weather story for this morning. Near zero around Dyersburg, 2 degrees above zero in Blytheville, Memphis International Airport at 7, Jackson, Tennessee at 4, and Tunica, not much better, at about 10 degrees above zero. Again, this is the combination of the winds with the temperature. How fast the winds are blowing and how cold the temperatures are gives you that mix about how it actually affects human tissue when you're outdoors for long periods of time. For those of you who want to get really nitpicky about it and say that this is not a real thing, it is a real thing. Wind chill does exist. It's a mathematical formula. You can look it up on the internet. I don't have time to do that right now because I'm doing the forecast for you, but it is a real thing. So before you start shouting about how it's not, it really is. Look it up. Great information on the internet, especially where it comes to scientific principles like that, so stay tuned for more on that. Currently at this time, again, dry conditions in the Mid-South, a few more clouds hanging around portions of the area around Poplar Pike, Germantown Road, the water towers north of Germantown High School, and looking off toward the towers of East Memphis, 17 degrees in Germantown, winds out of the east at about 8 miles per hour, so that's giving you a wind chill back to around 7 degrees for this morning. Very nice sunrise taking place. If you've got weather pictures, we'd love to see them so we can feature them on here, but we can't show them if you don't send them, so send them along. Downtown Memphis, Peabody Hotel, duckies snuggled away nicely in their duck palace up there, and a bit of a northerly breeze with Old Glory waving proudly up there so far this morning. 19 in West Memphis. Thank you, James Edwards, for checking on in for this morning, and thanks to everybody else who's checking in on the comments section for right now. 155 days until summer. Brittany Sutton, no, not quite. We have a little bit less time than that. I'll see if I can bring up the countdown clock here in just a little bit. 16.6 in Rosemark. Thank you, Dottie Fleming Ray, for that. Thank you for everybody for checking in for this morning. Airport delays looking back toward Memphis International for this morning. The good news at this time is that we don't have much of any delays to report. That green icon indicates delays of 15 minutes or less, so definitely good news on that. Again, see, summer solstice, for those of you who are asking about that, just a little while ago, let's see, who was that here? just a minute, 155 days till summer, Brittany Sutton, actually until the summer solstice, 174 days, 19 hours. So there you go, in case you wondered how far summer was away from the Mid-South area. 18 in Marion, Jeff Joyner, thank you very much. Brittany Sutton, 14 in Jackson, Tennessee, thank you very much. 16 degrees in Horn Lake, Mississippi, thank you Annie Kelly for that. If you or anybody else you know are traveling, no major delays reported at these airports, but if you'd like to check out this information for yourself, fly.faa.gov, great opportunity to see more about what's going on out there with travel delays and a lot of people in motion, not just around Memphis International, but throughout the rest of the country. So if you'd like to know more about travel conditions, got a lot of information there. Yesterday, we were seeing a decent amount of snow showers over parts of northern Mississippi, southeast Arkansas. That is definitely not the case for this morning. Sunrise spike, the radar detecting the rising sun on the horizon. Kind of neat to be able to see that there. But so far, not seeing much of anything in the Mid-South or heading our direction. So very quiet for right now. Later toward this weekend, well back to our west, snow showers could be developing. We'll talk more about that coming up here in just a little bit. Donna Vales, hope I'm saying that right. Thank you very much for the kind words. 15 degrees in Bolivar. Thank you very much. 17 in Walls. Thank you very much, Julia Cavallo, for that. And 17 also in Osceola, Arkansas. Pamela Scott, if I'm reading that right. Bifocals need cleaning. Sorry about that. Currently in the mid to upper teens, these right here, I wish I was kidding about it, but these are the warmest numbers in the Mid-South on the WeatherNet 3 network. Tunica checking in at 19 degrees at the airport, 18 degrees at Heidelberg Elementary, 17 degrees at both airports in West Memphis and Memphis International for this morning. Winds are, again, the main problem, up to about 10 miles per hour. Combine that with the wind chills, with the temperature, you get the wind chills, and that's what it feels like out there. So we've got some temperatures easily down around zero for right now. So please keep that in mind if you or the kids are going to be going outdoors anytime soon. Rest of the forecast, running the numbers into the rest of the day, seeing some interesting numbers on here as we approach the maximum heat of the day. I think the computers are a little bit kind of hedging their bets a little bit with these northerly winds coming in. The computers think that the numbers are going to be a little colder. I'm saying with the extra sunshine that the numbers here will be much warmer, not by much, but much warmer than what we're seeing here. Should be around the lower to mid 30s across much of the rest of the Mid-South for today. That extra sunshine can help you out, open up those blinds and the drapes and get some free solar heating going on that might help to take the edge off of your utility bill coming up in the next couple of weeks. So something to keep an eye on there. So again, computer says a little chillier here for today. I say with the extra sunshine, even though the winds will be out of the northeast, it'll probably be a little bit better on the conditions out there for today than what it has been over the last couple of days, and slight improvement into tomorrow as well. News Channel 3's Jim Jaggers on the air tonight on News Channel 3 at 10, mid to upper 20s to around lower 30s there, and into very early tomorrow, the lines on screen moving around, that's the winds showing again more light and variable conditions, so not much more of a wind chill tomorrow, and temperatures not quite as cold, lows only dropping to the mid to upper 20s to right about 30 degrees, so that's some good news. Dry into tomorrow as well. Now, let's take a look and see what's going to be going on in the extended forecast as we go throughout the rest of the next couple of days. Rebecca Bagwell, or Joseph Bagwell, 13 degrees, minus one wind chill in Maynard, Arkansas. Thank you very much. Rebecca Bagwell, 13 degrees. Thank you very much for Maynard. Appreciate that. Brandon Cross, minus three in Alaska. That's a big state. Any location specific on that? If you're around Anchorage, say hello to my friends Scott and Kerry Groon up around that area. So thank you very much for checking on in. Rose Wheeler, Lehigh Acres, Florida, 60 degrees. Wow, not fair. Thank you very much for checking in on that one for there. Horn Lake, temperature of 17. Daniel Lee Arata, thank you very much. 11 in Mountain Home, Arkansas. Thank you, Charles Hood. And 16 in Eads, Jeff Livingston. Thank you very much on that. All right, now we get into the weekend. Early New Year's Eve day. We start to see the potential for some more snow showers taking place back out to the west. The Ark-La-Tex area back into southern Missouri, southern Kansas will see this activity first and then developing and then moving a little closer to the Mid-South right as we go into around New Year's Eve festivity times. Wow, we need to get this screen clean. Sorry about that. This is, again, going to be just one potential. This is the best computer model that I've been able to see at this time as to what we may be looking for out there. The signs are there of something happening. The amounts and the exact type of precipitation, that right now is still way too early to tell. But these are interesting signs that we are seeing in the computer models at this time. And again, as we go into Sunday evening, right about the time we're getting ready to set up for all the parties that are going to be starting, this could be a bit of a problem out there. Again, snowfall potential coming back into the Mid-South looking a lot better in these computer model runs than what we've seen for today, and mainly going to be going, it looks like, into the areas of southeast Arkansas and right back into northern portions of Mississippi. Sorry about the gigantic word right there for Memphis. It should be a little smaller, but unfortunately sometimes the computer enlarges it because we're looking at it from a very big vantage point like this, so it's nice to be able to see it. Now again, that's snowfall potential. What are we looking at for anything else at this point in time? As we get into around Sunday evening, there is the potential of some mixture of precipitation. So again, into around areas of southern Arkansas and northern half of Mississippi, some snow showers along the northern edge of this, but then as we get into the evening hours, could be some type of precipitation mixture, depending on the temperatures of different layers of the atmosphere. The atmosphere is not the same temperature all the way up to the edge of space. There are differences, and especially at this time of the year, several hundred to several thousand feet off the ground, if you get enough cold air sitting in place, some of that moisture dropping down from several thousand feet up can freeze before it hits the ground, or it could be warmer at that level, and you could see liquid rainfall coming down and freezing on the roadway surfaces, the sidewalks, stuff like that. Right now, the general idea is that we're going to be getting something in the form of frozen or freezing precipitation. Snow on the northern edge of this, but then again, across northern Mississippi, southeast Arkansas, we could be looking at some mixture of precipitation, something involving rain, freezing rain, sleet, snow, grapple, things like that. Grapple is larger sleet sizes, but small enough to not be considered hail. So we could be seeing any mixture of that as we go into the evening hours. So if you have any plans for New Year's Eve, whether it's the church service, doing some reflecting at the end of the year, going to a friend's house, partying on Beale Street, this is something that doesn't look like a major threat at this time, but it definitely does look like it is changing for the better possibility of winter precipitation in the Mid-South area. So we will keep our eyes on that here at News Channel 3. You can keep up to date again at, let me see which way am I pointing here, wreg.com/weather if you'd like to keep up to date with that. And again, you can see more on the 7-day forecast down here. That's also available at wreg.com/weather at this time. Rest of the forecast, again, running the numbers into today, temperatures back in the lower to mid 30s. Dry and sunny skies, so a little bit of bright sunshine should help to, again, hopefully warm some places up with that free solar heating going on. 30 degrees in Texoma. Angela Tony, if I'm saying that right, hopefully. Thank you very much for checking in for this morning, and everybody else for checking in as well. Another check of the forecast throughout the rest of the morning. Rest of the week into this weekend, lower 40s. Again, that's not exactly normal, but it's also a lot warmer than what we've seen over the last couple of days there, so a few more clouds expected. Now, getting into the holidays itself, again, the last portion of the holidays, very cold for Sunday, temperatures back in the mid-20s for highs. Getting into New Year's Eve, into New Year's Day, bright and early on Monday morning next, back in the mid-teens for low temperatures, and again, could be looking at that potential of some frozen and or freezing precipitation. It doesn't look like much right now, 20% for the metro area and 10% into early New Year's Day, but the potential is still there, so keep it tuned for that. Now, as you go back to work or school next week around Tuesday, a lot of places are going to be heading back very early on January the 2nd, so at the bus stop on Tuesday morning, temperatures near 10 degrees in parts of the Mid-South. That's not exactly the 5-degree reading we had a couple of days ago, but that's still pretty chilly, so something to think about there. Rest of the week, staying in the lower to mid-30s, reinforcing shot of cool air around Thursday to drop our temperatures a bit, recouping the temperatures on Friday, and then going toward the 40s by the first weekend of 2018. and maybe the possibility of some scattered showers or snow showers there. This is still about 10 to 14 days out. So again, another storm system could be brewing somewhere out there by the end of next weekend. So definitely something that we are going to be keeping as possibility out there for the rest of the next couple of days. But this one right here is what we're going to be focusing on as the next potential weather maker for the area, and something you should be paying attention to as well. If you've got friends, loved ones, kids going to be traveling for the holidays, maybe getting back to school sometime pretty soon. I got my own kids who are going to be heading out for visiting relatives and friends and stuff like that. So Mr. Gates on time right there. Looking again at the possibility of that going to be the main problem out there, so we'll keep our eyes on that over the course of the next couple of days. We'll have an extended version of Weather Overtime that'll be coming up on my Facebook page at about 10:30 this morning. Again, that'll be at www.facebook.com/austinonic, W-R-E-G. Wherever you're at out there, you can find me on the social media networks, and we'll keep you updated. You can also find me again by going directly to wrg.com/weather, and we'll keep you updated on that. Rest of the morning, pretty chilly. We'll have updates on News Channel 3 as we go throughout the rest of the morning, and on Live at 9 and on News Channel 3 at noon, so stick around for that. And, of course, Weather Overtime that'll be coming up at about 10:30 this morning, live and direct from here in the studio. I'm meteorologist Austin Onick. Thanks for joining us for a quick weather update on Facebook for our main News Channel 3 Facebook page. I got to get ready to go for our new updates coming up here in just a little bit. So stay tuned to News Channel 3 on air and online throughout the rest of the morning for updates.